Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to worship on this, the second Sunday after Easter. Did you know that today is called Low Sunday? It's called Low Sunday because attendance is generally lower, and after a busy, busy Holy Week, sometimes people's euphoria kind of comes down, but I'm going to invite each of you to maximize your spirit potential today and really worship hard so it doesn't seem like Low Sunday. I want to thank everyone who brought a guest to worship last week. It was really lovely to see old friends and make some new ones. I also want to thank Bonnie and Cheryl for representing Westbrook-Warren at the cleanup, the Riverwalk cleanup yesterday. Yeah.
Yeah.
And John,
where was John?
I got there late.
Oh, well, okay, and John too. We found lots of exciting things down there. So, thank you. Couple of announcements. Church Council is going to be tomorrow night here. Also, CMO is, worshiping. but you can worship. Is meeting after worship in Fellowship Hall. Other announcements, you may have noticed that next to the prayer board is a basket of batteries. Why batteries? Well, somebody donated all those batteries to the church, and even when the church is up and fully operational, we cannot use all those batteries. So there are a bunch of AA batteries. I put some baggies out there so you don't have to load your pockets up. All right. There is a potting event next Saturday morning at 9 a.m. Now, for you folks that like cannabis, that is not a marijuana event. We're going to be potting plants for the Mother's Day and repotting plants for the Mother's Day sale the following week. It's going to be down in the CE space. That's where we're collecting pots and plants and all those kinds of things. And then finally, Mother's Day is in 2 weeks, right? Right? We're having the plant sale the day before, but next Sunday, I want to invite each of you to go through old photos and bring a photo of your mom or some other influential figure in your life. Gender does not matter. And you might want to write your name on it. And if you could bring it next week, then we can work with it and create a display for Mother's Day Sunday. Along similar lines, I'm going to be speaking with the women's group when the women's group meets. And this is just an early plug. Bring a picture of your grandmother or somebody who filled that role for you. So, pictures. Got it? Any other announcements before? Yes, John.
Yard sale is officially on the calendar. It is June 24th and 25th.
Great. Awesome. If for those that didn't hear that, the yard sale is on the calendar for late June. So that's exciting. All right, let us prepare our hearts for worship.
Responsive call to worship. In a culture that seems polarized by the simplest things, it is difficult to take a stand. Talking about our faith is no different. If we talk too much about Jesus, people might think we are holy rollers. And yet, my faith in Christ has given me strength, even in the most trying of circumstances. He is the reason I am here today, and I will talk about his goodness for the rest of my life.
But people judge me. My faith has carried me when nothing else could.
In this place, we have permission to speak freely about God, what God has done. Yes, many of us come up short on our monthly bills, but somehow God saw us through. Tests came and tests went this week, but we passed the most important test of all, the test of faith. In this house, there is no gag order against testifying to what great things God has done.
Let people judge me. My faith has carried me when nothing else could, and I am here to give God thanks and praise.
Our opening prayer, our opening hymn is Morning Has Broken, and the in the Blue Book 38.
Dynamic Christian communities, so energize us with creativity that we might share Christ's light and your love with the world in new and inspired ways. As your Spirit gave courage for them to stand tall before the powers of this world, so empower us to proclaim your gospel and struggle for what is good and right and true. By your presence with us now, make us one in love and mission. For we ask this through Jesus Christ, in whose name we pray, saying, Our Creator, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Amen. Kids, I'd invite the kids to come down, or kids at heart. Izzy, did you get a new haircut? You did. You can have a seat anywhere right there. How are you today?
Good.
Yeah, good. Kyle says hi. He couldn't be here today, but he's looking forward to seeing you soon. You know, often when we come here to church, we get inspired or excited. She's like, Mom, do I have to come down? By things that we read from the Bible. There are stories that talk about our faith and God, and those stories can give us the strength to do things out in the world, to make hard choices, to be kind to people when people aren't so kind to us. But you know something, and you probably know this better than any kid in here, that music can do the same thing. Do you know anybody that likes music? Maybe your mom? Does she like music? She gets paid to do music, doesn't she? Yeah, she does. Well, I wanted to share a song with you that's a church song that helps me understand how the world works. And it's called In the Bulb There's a Flower. And it goes like this. In the bulb there's a flower, in the seed an apple tree. And an apple tree comes from a really small seed. In cocoons, what's in a cocoon?
A rabbit.
A rabbit? Well, most cocoons have a butterfly, right? So in cocoon, a hidden promise, butterflies will soon be free. In the cold and snow of winter, there's a spring that waits to be unrevealed, meaning you can't see it until its season, something God alone can see. It goes on to say, there's a song in every silence. Think about that, that's a hard one. Seeking word and melody, there's a dawn, meaning the light's coming, right? Early morning. And every darkness bringing hope to you and me. Because if we got a new day, that's a good thing. From the past will come the future. What it holds, mystery, right? We don't really know what's going to happen tomorrow. Unrevealed, meaning you can't see it until it's season. Something God alone could see. So I think that song, for me, that song means that even though we can't always see things and know what's going to happen tomorrow, that the God that we've come here to worship knows, right? And is trying to make something good come out of whatever tomorrow holds. Kind of like a bulb in a flower, right? We can't see. Cheryl Durda and John, raise your hand. These kind people went out before worship. John's in the back.
Todd.
Oh, I'm sorry. You see how that works? Todd. Wait, see? That's Todd. Todd went out before worship and got these for me. So this song is talking about, oh, this is more like a root thing. Okay, in this root is a flower. So what I'm going to do is give you one of these kits, and it's got stuff in here that'll help make it grow. And we might not be able to see the flower today, but we're going to trust that when it's taken care of, that it's gonna bloom into something beautiful. How cool is that? Okay, I'm going to let you pick a color. This is kind of pinkish, orange, or yellow?
Pink.
Okay, there you go. Let's pray. Great and awesome God, we give you thanks. Thanks for the many blessings in our lives and for the blessings that are yet to be. Just like the blessing of Izzy. She is a blessing here and now, but we know that you are working in her and through her that she might someday become the person that you need her to be. We ask your blessing upon her, and I ask your blessing upon each one of us here today that we might be beautiful flowers in your garden of love. In Christ's name, amen. Let us continue our worship with a song of praise. Oh, share a little peace.
Peace.
And then we sing. Trumpet sound. Praise him with lute and harp. Praise him with tambourine and dance. Praise him with strings and pipes. Praise him with clanging cymbals. Praise him with loud clashing cymbals. Let everything that breathes praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. is cool. This morning's gospel lesson offers us three stories in 12 verses. They are Jesus' appearance to the disciples, an exchange between Jesus and Thomas, which led to Thomas' name becoming a euphemism for all eternity. Think about that. 2,000 plus years, he's been known for this conversation. And then the purpose of this book. And all of that is wrapped up in these short lines. So let us explore these passages together, shall we? We're looking at John 20, verses 19 through 31. When it was evening on that first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." But Thomas, who was called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails on his hands and put my fingers into the mark of the nails and my hand in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood with them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have yet come to believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of the disciples, which are written in this book. But these are written so that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through believing, you may have life in his name. My friends, this is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
imperfect world. So in our imperfect world, on this side of eternity, sometimes it's hard to be grateful, even. It's difficult to see a bulb and envision the flower that it's going to become. But we worship a God of verbs. Not herbs, verbs. One who consistently calls us to action, to growing, to budding, to blooming. A God who sends and creates and forgives. Take, for example, this scripture lesson from the Gospel of John. As the Father has sent me, so I send you. When he had said this, he breathed upon them, and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." Sending is what God does. Jesus is sent. The Holy Spirit is sent. We are sent as well. Now, you may think that the pandemic has put an end to the work of the church. But no, no, especially not now. No, God is like, well, there's work to be done. You need to get yourself out there and start taking more risks. Jesus, as he stood among the disciples on the other side of eternity, gave instructions. And we, like the disciples, are given the same instructions. So the disciples stood on this side of eternity, and we too stand on this side of eternity, or maybe we sit on this side of eternity in the here and now. And like those early disciples, we are charged with receiving the Holy Spirit, drinking it in fully, and then going out beyond the safety of the doors that keep us secure, to share the love of God, which cannot be contained, could not be contained by a grave, cannot be contained by walls or masks or anything. Jesus directs us beyond the moment, whatever that is for you, toward a living life out loud. We are to raise our voices, to bear witness to the good news, which is precisely why sharing our stories is so important. For the past couple of years, we've lived in relative isolation, as if we were stuck in a bulb or hidden away in an upper room, closed behind doors. Uncommon conversations have become, well, less common. But the living Christ sends us out to boldly go where no one has gone before, to bear witness to the ways in which our belief in God, a God who sent a piece of divinity to the earth and has promised humankind life beyond this one, and to call it real, and to call that Christ the living Christ, that Christ lives on. How many times has that God brought you back from the brink of physical or emotional death, or has transformed something horrible into something good? Anyone? Has that happened? Oh, good. Good. All right. So we're going to do this exercise because we've got to get out of our upper rooms. I want you to find somebody close to you. Could be in your germ family, could be not. Alicia, you're my person for this exercise. And I want to invite you now to find that person and to share a time when God has been very real and very present for you. All right? And then we're going to come back. And you can do it with three people. If you're sitting among, you know, a cluster of three. All right, well, let's kind of come back to this space. If you didn't get to share your story in full, connect elsewhere. I shared a story with Alicia, and I heard her mentioning it to Julie, and that's how the word spread, right? I mean, that's how it happens. Ah, oh, good. Well, thank you. Thank you for indulging me.
Thank you for indulging
me. This is what we haven't been doing. At least I haven't. I know some of you are really good about sending cards and picking up the phone, but there were days during this pandemic when it was all I could do just to get the clothes washed and the food on the table, and the, you know?
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank you for indulging me. In the same way that Jesus came and shared our lot, our common lot, we are called to open ourselves to others, to hear their stories, and to share our own so that, well, people know that they are not alone. I mean, that's one of the things that Jesus does for me, is reminds me that as bad as my worst day is, I'm not alone in it. We are equally called to open ourselves to the Holy Spirit. That's what this passage calls the disciples to do, to open themselves to trusting in something bigger than themselves when all else seemed lost. So we're called to open ourselves to the Holy Spirit through prayer and the Bible and music, because on this side of eternity, when there is a lot of information competing for space in our heads, the gospel tells us, reminds us that Jesus is our Messiah, that Jesus is the Son of God, that Jesus is the Prince of Peace that will have the last word in the Ukraine, in Afghanistan, in people's homes and hearts, that Jesus is the light of the world. That through believing in him, through worshiping him, through serving him, we can find meaning and healing and redemption and purpose. Jesus' death is a reminder that all of this is temporary, and it's going to fade away someday. But the promise of God is eternal life. But on this side of eternity, when all seems lost, when the economy seems unstable, when the pandemic, another wave, comes through, when violence looms large, we only have one strength, and that is in Jesus Christ. No matter how heavy our current burdens may be, as long as we have Christ, things will eventually work out. There is a bulb. Well, there's a bulb, but there's a flower in every bulb, right? I want to shift to a time of prayer, and I'm going to be quiet, and I invite you to lift up that person that or persons you were sharing stories with and ask God's blessing upon those people, and then lift up any prayers that are utmost on your heart. Will you be with me in a spirit of prayer? Gracious God, be with Alicia and Danny and baby Ben. We hear your calling, Lord. How can we keep from singing? May we with confidence proclaim the good news that Christ is risen. Inspired by his life, may we bring healing and forgiveness to others. Today we've named out loud and in the silence of our hearts people who are important to us. We also want to lift up in prayer those who are struggling with meaning, with identity, with physical and emotional challenges, with financial concerns, with addiction, anxiety, depression. Holy One, you know who these people are, and we ask that you heal them from the inside out. Remind them, as you have reminded us, that they are not alone, and guide them in right path. On this second Sunday of Easter, whether we have seen and believed or believe without seeing, we have found life in Jesus' name. And for that, we are forever grateful. O Prince of Peace, reign in our hearts and in our homes. Shower the world with love and compassion. Wipe away sin and anger, resentment and greed. that together we might usher in your kingdom, which has no end. Gracious God, until that day when we are reunited with you and all the company in heaven, we offer these prayers in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. To bring our offering forward and join in singing the Easter doxology, will you? And loving God, we give you thanks for the opportunity to gather here freely and to worship you in Christ's name. We ask your blessing upon these gifts, that they might be used to your service and glory, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Oh, word. Share God's love with those you meet. Bring hope to those who are in despair. Live lives of gratitude and praise. And may the love of God, the peace of Jesus Christ, and the presence of the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen.